walk a bit different now. Now that my heart's been found, nothing really feels the same. I hold my head a bit higher, I lift my voice a bit louder. Yeah, something inside has changed. I am a mountain mover, water walker, more than just an overcomer, 'cause I've been set free. I am a gospel preacher, heart on fire, freedom singer, testifier, 'cause I've been redeemed. I am a believer. I am a believer. I know this is not my home. I know I don't walk alone. No matter what comes my way, I have peace through the trouble, I have joy through the struggle. Now my hope's in a brighter day. I am a mountain mover, water walker, more than just an overcomer, 'cause I've been set free. I am a gospel preacher, heart on fire, freedom singer, testifier, 'cause I've been redeemed. I am a believer. Oh, I am a child of the Father, and nothing, no longer, no doubt about who I am. I'm in the hands of the healer, the arms of the Savior. His grace makes me who I am.
Hey kids, Pastor Nick here again. I know that we can't have Glow, and I miss it, I hate it so much, but we're still going to be connected just like this. I'm gonna give you a little devotion every week, so please keep tuning in every Wednesday and checking out what we're doing. It's Holy Week, and that is this wonderful time where it's the last week of Jesus' life, right before he goes to the cross and he's crucified, and certainly before Easter morning when he is risen from the grave. This is that time where we celebrate the last days of Jesus. And every day is so important. And what makes this week so special is because we look at the end whenever Jesus, not hanging on the cross, but he's in the tomb. And the disciples and everyone think that he's gone forever, that this is the end. Well, on the third day, Jesus raises again. He rises from the dead. And on that third day, we find that the tomb is empty. He is alive. He's defeated death. And how awesome is that? Well, that's so important if we understand and know that Jesus did all that to save us of our sin. Sin is what makes this whole week so important and so big, because before Jesus went to the cross and died, sin had a hold of us. And we didn't have any way of getting rid of it. It was defeating all of humanity. Well, Jesus died to save us of that sin. Well, I want to explain what that means just a little bit and understand why this week is so important. And I'm going to use a piece of rope to do that. And we're going to go all the way back to the very first book of the Bible. If you know what that book is, go ahead and shout it out. What is the very first book of the Bible? One, two, three, go. That's right, it's Genesis. And in the book of Genesis, we have this story of creation where God made everything. He made the heavens and the earth and the sun, the moon, the stars, the water, the plants, He made the animals, and also he made you and he made me. He made the first man, the first woman, that's Adam and Eve. And as God created all of these things and ended with the first man and the first woman, he looked at all of his creation, and the Bible says that he said these words, "It is very good." He loved his creation. And he loved his creation so much, he made a special place for his creation to live. He brought Adam and Eve, and he put them in this wonderful garden, the Garden of Eden. And he said, "This is where you shall live and work, and this is going to be awesome." This place was perfect. There was no hardship. There was no sadness. This was just a perfect place of harmony between man and between God. And that's what we find is in the Garden of Eden. The Bible says that God walked with Adam and Eve. He was with them. They could see him in this garden. And so just like this rope, here's what we see. Adam and Eve was on this side. God was over here, and they were connected. It was just this straight line connecting them. There was no broken pieces, no knots, nothing. They were connected to God and had the perfect relationship. Well, God told Adam and Eve that they could eat of any fruit and plant in the garden, but there was one that they had to stay away from. One tree that they could not eat from, and that was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And Adam and Eve understood that. They knew this is the tree they could not eat from. Well, as the book goes on, we see that there is a serpent that comes in, a snake that makes his way into the story. And Adam and Eve were in the garden one day, and that snake comes up and tempts Eve. And Eve, she looks and understands that she's not supposed to eat from this tree, but she does so anyway. And as she eats from this tree, something happens in the garden. As she eats from this tree, the relationship that Adam and Eve had with God, it was broken. It was cut in two. And so now they didn't have this perfect relationship. In fact, the Bible says that because of that moment, that act, sin entered the world, and Adam and Eve were kicked out of the garden. Well, God, he didn't want to leave his creation to suffering, so he puts a plan in motion. And the plan he puts in motion is found in a man called Abraham. And he says to Abraham that I am going to bless all the nations of the world through you. And so as he does, God makes a plan where he ties the relationship together. And so through Abraham, he says, all the nations are going to be blessed through you. You will find a pathway back to me. And so Abraham and all of humanity and God will be able to be connected. But look, it's not perfect. They're tied together. There's this big knot here that's holding them together. It's not that perfect relationship that was found in the garden. There was that knot. And that knot is because of sin. Sin is what allowed for this knot to happen. God's grace has still kept humanity and him together, but it's broken. Well, God, he kept that promise. And many years went by, and a child was born, and that child's name was Jesus. And Jesus enters the scene. And as Jesus comes on the scene, he lives a perfect life. He never sins. He never messes up. He doesn't disobey his mom or his dad. He never lies. He doesn't steal. He lives a perfect life. And Jesus said these words, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." Jesus says, if you want that relationship to be restored, it has to happen through me. And so something happens this last week. Jesus, this last week, as he comes on the scene, he does something just amazing. He gets betrayed, and he goes to a cross. And the Bible says, as he goes to the cross, all the sin of the world comes upon him. So every lie you've ever told, every thought that you ever had that wasn't a good thought, every word that came out of your mouth that wasn't pure, God took all of those sins upon him. And the Bible says that as he died, that sin was with him. But the Bible also says that he rose again. And here's the wonderful thing, because Jesus is alive, he defeated death and he conquered sin. The Bible says that if we will call upon him, he will take our sin and he'll throw it as far as the east is from the west. And he remembers it no more. It's gone. And the Bible also says if we confess our sin and call upon him and ask him to be our Lord and Savior, we want to live for him. The Bible says that then he will take and he will restore our relationship to God. It'll be perfect. There'll be no broken pieces. There'll be no knots. We're not tied together. We're perfect in relationship with God because Jesus has done that. Boys and girls, today I want to ask you, do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Have you ever asked Him to be more than just a name you've heard at church, to be more than just a story, but to truly be your Lord, your Savior, to forgive you of your sins and to restore a broken relationship? And He'll do so. If you have any questions, talk to your mom, talk to your dad, and they'll be glad to answer them. But guys, I want you to know, this week is so important because when Jesus rose again, He fixed the relationship that was broken for thousands of years. How great is Jesus?